Hey, what's up, guys? It's your boy Phantom, back at you another video today, and I'm back. Sorry for the 3-day break. I haven't uploaded in 3 whole days. My apologies. I've been too busy playing Soul Calibur 6, as you guys can see on the screen right here. Now, without a further ado, I'm sure you guys already know I love this game. This game is very fun. I've waited so long for this game to come out. Literally, it was the longest wait of my life, and it is finally here, and I love it. This game is so much fun. But today, in this video, I'm going to just do a quick little video showing off my the characters I created in Soul Calibur 6. You know what I'm saying? I think my characters look pretty awesome. I love that, you know, the character creator system in this game is bringing so many people, you know, having so many people play the game and bringing so many people who normally wouldn't even probably play fighting games to play Soul Calibur. And I love it. You know, it's an awesome character creator. It's a lot of fun. I love seeing all the people's characters online and fighting against them. It's just a really good time. And I just want to show off my characters as well. But before we get the video started, I want to let you guys know, go ahead and if you guys enjoy the video, go ahead and give the video a quick thumbs up. Comment down below your thoughts. You know what I'm saying? If you guys have Soul Calibur, what characters you guys created, what's their name, their backstory, their lore, let's get a discussion started, let's have some fun. You know what I'm saying? Make sure you subscribe to the channel if you're new, if you enjoyed the video, for some Soul Calibur 6 content, other content I post as well. Also, if you guys like the content I produce and really want to support the channel, maybe consider donating to the channel. Once again, I have a PayPal link in the description below to donate straight to PayPal. You know what I'm saying? All proceeds will go straight to the channel to make the channel overall better for you guys to enjoy. Also, hashtag Team No Sleep down below in the comment section. If y'all are part of Team No Sleep, go ahead and hashtag it down below. Team No Sleep is a new movement that we're going to be doing. If you don't want to sleep, if you want to stay up all day, Team No Sleep in the comment section below. Without a further ado, let's go ahead and get the video started. Sorry guys, I gotta say all that stuff. YouTube told me to. Sorry. Alright, so here's a list of all my characters right here I've created so far on Soul Calibur 6. As you can see, I've made quite a number of characters. Well, actually, this isn't really a lot of characters. I've seen people on Twitter who've like maxed out their stuff already, I think, which is kind of crazy considering how many slots you have. As you guys can see on the bottom right there, you got 100 slots to create your characters. I've used only 14 so far. So yeah, I've seen people max this out already, so that's a little wild, but I have spent some time in this character creator, and I love it to death. I love it. I already knew I was going to spend a lot of time in here, and I've made quite a lot of awesome characters. So I'm just going to go through and show you every single character. I've got some kind of backstory and lore. I've got like a backstory and lore for all my characters, at least most of them at least. I'm just going to go ahead and show and give you guys a brief look at their backstory, a brief look at their design, you know what I'm saying? Give you a little full 360 shot and make have you guys look at them. And yeah, I think I did a pretty awesome job with some of these characters. I will say though, the first few characters I created are kind of basic because I was just kind of making stuff, and as I went along and as I spent more time in the character creator, you notice that my characters, as you go down further, start to look more and more detailed in certain ways. So yeah, but let's go ahead and start with the first one. Let's go ahead and start with V. All right, so this is V. His name is V. Now V, here's his backstory, right? Also, before I start with the backstory lore crap, I try to make my characters, when I made my characters, I wanted to kind of like insert them into the world of Soul Calibur. So I'm not making like anime characters or anything. I'm making characters that would fit into Soul Calibur in my own imagination. So all these characters kind of, I feel like, have some kind of connection to the like Soul Calibur, you know. So I feel like that just makes the most sense, you know. But let's go ahead and start off with V. So this is my first character I created when I first got to the character creator. His name is V, as you guys can see. He has Raphael's fighting style, who's a really cool character, by the way. V's an aristocratic male. He's a very aristocrat kind of guy, you know what I'm saying? As you can see though, his skin is pale and his eyes are red. Let me go and get a zoom in right there. V himself is a very charismatic man, you know what I'm saying? Everybody looks up to V. He's a very charming guy, very kind of noble, aristocrat kind of guy, sipping tea and always sitting there with a rocking cane, you know what I'm saying? He's a really cool guy, talks to the ladies real smooth, but underneath that facade, he has evil intentions in mind. He's the leader of an organization known as the Black Creed. The Black Creed are known for many crimes such as assassination, murder, and stuff like that. But he's also, of course, looking for Soul Edge for himself to get the power of Soul Edge and increase his power and his wealth over the world. So yeah, basically V's kind of like a villain character. He's the villain character I kind of created for my creative character. As you guys can see, this is his full design. I didn't really go too crazy with him, but I am satisfied with how I did him. All right, so these next three characters, I'm actually gonna end up remaking these next three characters. So I'm not even really gonna show them. No, actually, I'll show Yojimbo, because I think Yojimbo is pretty cool. He's my coolest character I think I made, but I didn't spend much time with him. As you can tell, he looks extremely basic. But he's supposed to be like some kind of undead samurai or undead Grim Reaper kind of, who walks around, you know, just he's basically a skeleton samurai. That's what he's supposed to be. But yeah, I don't really like his design, so I'm most likely gonna remake him in the future. But this is Yojimbo in his current form. All right, so this is Mist. Now Mist is supposed to be like some kind of outcast samurai, kind of like Mitsurugi. As you guys can see, she has Mitsurugi's fighting style, kind of like Baiken. As you guys can tell, I based my design off of Baiken from Guilty Gear a little bit. Pink hair, eye patch. Yeah, you could tell. She has little tattoos right there. She looks like a cool character, but I am gonna probably remake her, so I have a cooler design in mind. So this is Lucille. Now Lucilia is an elf. As you can see, she has her little pony ears right there. If you guys can't see, let me go ahead and close in on those ears. She has a little pointy ears right there. This is Lucilia. I may not remake Lucilia. I mean, I think she looks okay, but I may kind of look at her again, you know what I mean? Because she looks kind of basic, but she's basically from the outcast elf clan, and you know, she's on the outskirts of the village. She's basically an all-time village girl, and she's basically traveling the land, just having a good time. She's just looking for adventure. That's why she is. I made her sister, so I'm gonna show her sister off, and her sister's in the last column. But yeah, this is Lucilia right here. She's basically just a happy-go-lucky girl who's just looking for a good time, man. Right, so this is one of my favorite characters right here. This is kind of where I started having a lot of fun with character creator. This is Coriana. Her name is Coriana. She is of Sophidius descent. Well, she's basically of Sophidius bloodline, the Greek Athens bloodline. And this is Coriana. Let me go ahead and zoom in on her. You guys can see she got some pretty, she's pretty well endowed about right there. Very muscular, very strong woman. So yeah, this is Coriana. She has Sophidius fighting style. Her backstory, a little bit of her lore is, originally she was kind of an outcast and an orphan, and she was found by Sophidia. And Sophidia kind of took her in and trained her as her surrogate daughter, or kind of like her adopted daughter a little bit, and kind of trained her and morphed her, you know, kind of morphed her into a warrior, basically. And so yeah, this is her right here. This is Coriana with her little wings right here. She looks a little bit like Sophidia, but she has a little Valkyrie armor on. Yeah, this Coriana looks dope. I love Coriana, and I play her a lot online, so expect to see her a lot more in the future. This right here is Amir. His name is Amir. Now, if you guys can see right here, he's basically my Assassin's Creed character. When I made him, I was kind of just basing off Assassin's Creed. I just want to make an Assassin's Creed character in the game. And they look really good. You can definitely make an Assassin's Creed character. It's really good. He has Geralt's fighting style. Geralt's fighting style is pretty cool. It fits him very perfectly. And as you guys can see, got a little close up right there. He's got a little mark on his face. Got a little pretty deep mark. You can't really see most of his face, of course, because he's an assassin, and I'm not gonna show his face. You'll be lucky to see his face, but that's Amir right there. But Amir's little short backstory is Amir used. So basically, back to V, the main antagonist of this whole character story. Amir used to be one of V's assassins for the Black Creed. He used to be an assassin for the Black Creed. Put him on a mission where Amir had to kill his best friend unknowingly. He unknowingly killed his best friend under V's orders. And you know what I'm saying? This, of course, saddened Amir a lot, depressed him, and he was very angered and very upset about this. So he, of course, abandoned the Black Creed, went rogue, went on a run, and is now looking to get back at V and put a stop to his evil plans, basically. So yep, that is Amir's backstory. He's looking for revenge, and of course, to atone for his sins of his past misdoings. So yeah, he's a pretty deep character, you know what I'm saying? So here we have Ilya. Now Ilya is one of Amir's accomplices, basically his teammate, one of his partners in crime. She's also an assassin, or kind of like a bounty hunter or so, or kind of like a rogue ninja. I don't really know what to call it. They're basically vigilantes who kind of, you know, fight for the sake of others or the greater good, you know what I'm saying? But they also take crime into their own hands. So I'm not sure what you call, I guess, yeah, vigilantes, basically. You know what I'm saying? Their methods are kind of not heroic, but they do stuff for the greater good, basically. And they're all trying to take down these organizations. So this is Ilya. She has Taki's fighting style, as you guys can see. She's basically a ninja. She is a ninja, basically. So you see she has her elf ears right here. I'm actually going to change that. It's been annoying me for the longest. I originally wanted her to be an elf character, but it doesn't really look good. The ears are kind of clipping out of here, and I'm just gonna change it. But I have to remake the whole character if I want to change it, so I'm gonna have to do that another time. She's a very cool character. She has the same exact mark that Amir has on her left eye. She has an all black skin tight suit on, looking pretty good. You know what I'm saying? She got her gauntlets, got Taki's fighting style, got a little hood on. She's basically an Assassin's Creed character. I made a lot of Assassin's Creed characters. I think they look really cool in this game. And this right here, this is Bayek. Now Bayek is, of course, the third teammate in Amir's little organization that he's put together to take down V, the little vigilante assassin organization. You know what I'm saying? Basically, that's all Bayek. Now, Bayek, of course, looks very similar to Ilya. They got the all black on, you know what I'm saying? Dressed in black. They attack at night in the shadows. He's kind of like a shadow warrior, you know what I'm saying? He got the little tattoos right there, as you guys can see. I put some tattoos on him. I got a little creative when I put some little tattoos on him. He's a very cool looking character. Oh man, okay, so this character right here, this character took me like, I think 2 hours to make. It took me like 2 hours to make her. This is Kali. Now Kali is back to V once again. This is one of V's highest ranking generals in the Black Creed organization, who are like kind of the villains of this series. They're all looking for Soul Edge, to use Soul Edge for their nefarious means to gain power. Now Kali, as you can see, is looking very undead. She's looking a lot more undead than V is, a lot more undead. She looks like a zombie. That's because she kind of is a zombie, but she's not really a zombie. So let me get a little close up on her. I put a lot of detail into Kali, just saying. This took me a long time to make. I got like blood splattered. You probably can't see it because it's so much black and gray going on, but I put a lot of detail in this character. You know, she has her leather coat on right here. She has the little patterns on her little bodysuit right there. She has blood on the bodysuit. You really can't tell it, unfortunately. It's hard to tell. She has it on her face as well, but once again, it's hard to tell because she's just so black. But yeah, this is my favorite. This is my coolest looking character, in my opinion, so far. At least my second coolest looking character. It took me a long time to make her. I spent a lot of time with her, put a lot of detail into her, and she's a very powerful character. So her backstory is basically, once again, she is one of the highest ranking generals in V's organization. She's undead for the most part. She's very evil. But yeah, for the most part, she's just kind of crazy. But she's a very powerful character. Very powerful character. She's Malfested. She has a lot of power. And she has Tira's fighting style. I love Tira in this game. I bought Tira. But personally, I think Tira sucks in this game. Just saying. Tira kind of sucks in this game. Not going to lie. But she is pretty fun to play. I do like Kali a lot. So this is Kali. This is one of my coolest looking characters I made. I'm going to give you guys a full 360 look. Yeah. I put a lot of time into this character. This is Stella. This is the daughter of V. This is V's daughter. V has a daughter. This is Stella right here. She has the silver hair. She has the white eyes, basically. And yeah, Stella's she's a very smart girl. Very, very smart girl. Very shy. Very to herself. Very introverted. But, you know, she is very, very good with the sword that her father has taught her. Now, Stella's little backstory is, you know what I'm saying, V is, of course, running his organization. He's a powerful dictator by day. And for the most part, a very loving father. A very supportive father at night to his daughter Stella. But Stella, of course, knows of her father's evil deeds and stuff like that, and she feels very indifferent towards him. So what her actions will be towards her father, we may never know. And this right here, this is my last character I created so far as I'm recording this video. This is Lilim. Now this is the sister of Lucilia, who I showed earlier. This is Lilim. This is her older sister. Lilim is, of course, an elf as well. She's of the Outcast clan. She kind of lives in the forest and stuff like that. But she's extremely powerful. She's one of the most powerful, you know, people in her clan. She's very, very powerful. She's also she's kind of snobby. kind of greedy. You know what I'm saying? So of course, with all that power, she's extremely childish, extremely greedy. She has the fighting style of Aswell, of course, totally fits. Aswell is a very fun character to play, just saying. Lilim's little backstory is that she's looking for Soul Edge as well. She's basically sitting at home with her sister, kind of just minding her own business, twiddling her thumbs and stuff like that. And she hears the stories of Soul Edge, and she wants to pursue the sword for herself, of course, to use it for her own power and gain. Now, Lilim, she's not really a hero character. I wouldn't really call her a hero. She kind of just does stuff for her own, like, greed and kind of her own desire. So she's not really like a hero character, but she's not a bad character either. As you can see, I spent a lot of time with her as well. Her and Kali took me all day to make. As you can see, she has her nice little pattern on. She has the tattoos on. I put a lot of tattoos on her. She has a back tattoo as well, right there. Yeah, she has a really, really awesome back tattoo. Yeah, I think Lilim looks great. Lilim looks amazing. I had a lot of fun making this character. She has like a huge arm tattoo. She has a tattoo on her chest. So yeah, Lilim, this is Lilim. One of my favorite looking characters so far, definitely. You know what I'm saying? This is when I kind of started having a lot more fun with character creator. So she looks really good. Alright, so those are all my characters I've made so far into Soul Calibur 6. Once again, of course, I'm going to make a lot more. So I may do an update video in the future, maybe. Definitely can't wait to upload some little videos on some of these characters. You know, it's a lot of fun playing them online because basically they just share the same moveset as the regular characters. So, I mean, it's not really an issue playing them online. I mean, they're basically just like, you know, just purely cosmetic and just pure fun. And that's what I like so much about this game. It's just a lot of fun. You know what I'm saying? There's nothing broken. There's no overpowered created characters, whatever. It's completely balanced. For the most part, it's very fun. It's just mindless fun, man. Just have a good time. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, thanks for watching again, guys. Make sure y'all comment down below if y'all, you know, have Soul Calibur 6. What characters y'all created? Your character's lore and stuff like that. Heck, maybe even shout me out on Twitter. Send me a picture. I love to look at it. I love seeing you guys. I love seeing other people's characters. So, because some people made some extremely cool characters. Not gonna lie, extremely cool. And I was super impressed by it. Yeah, Twitter, dudes go crazy on this thing. But yeah, guys, I had so much fun with this character creator. I'm so glad, you know, so many people are playing Soul Calibur 6 now. You know what I'm saying? It's an amazingly fun game. And hopefully this video will help some of you guys maybe even look into the game. Maybe look into getting the game for yourself. Because it's a lot of fun. You know what I'm saying? But thanks for watching once again. Remember to like, comment, subscribe. And yeah, enjoy the rest of the fight right here in this video.
The battle is over. Show respect for the fallen who fought so bravely.